Venice might not be much to look at, but then again, neither is Dutch Harbor. And that town does $190 million in seafood every year. Don't judge a port by its cover.
All righty, y'all ready?
All right, day one Venice, here we go.
I'm leaving out of Venice Marina. I'm gonna head out east, chase some tunas for the rest of the day.
Basically, we're gonna be going down the Mississippi to get to the outside. So what I've heard is the reason this fishing is so good here, you get all the nutrients coming out from the river, and the river's carved all these canyons, and that brings in the bait, which brings in the bigger fish, which brings in the bigger fish, so.
That makes sense. Leaving Venice means you've got to navigate the canals of the Mississippi Delta. There's access to the east and the west, which means access no matter which way the wind is blowing. The good news is the deep water rigs are much closer.
There's a couple right there. Coming into a couple marks right now.
There's another mark right there.
Couple marks.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, a bunt.
All righty, boys. Get the bucket ready and we're home over.
Okay.
Let him go.
You see some marks, be go time, baby.
Let him fly. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Freebies deployed.
Oh, who's that? Who's that?
Keep it tight. Keep it tight. Don't let it go slack.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he's on it.
He's pissed.
There you go, buddy.
Out here, we're using lighter tackle than Hawaii, but still targeting fish that can weigh up to 200 pounds. It's a finesse game, but one hell of a workout. Get a fight in my hand and keep them away from the oil rigs.
And I'll tell you what, if I had to bring in 50 of these a day, I would have a serious problem.
Need some greasing and oil in some of these.
Here, Bill. Show me how it's done.
Yeah, he's like under the boat.
Come ahead a little, boss.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
Let's grab the harness on, buddy.
Yeah, I guess, huh?
You're an animal.
This is not uncommon at the end to put the harness on.
Hold on, I'm coming.
What are we doing? Put it on. I'm not asking.
Josh, yes, just Velcro it in the back. Put it tighter. Okay.
I got the pole, buddy, for a second.
Definitely man versus fish right now. There he comes.
There he goes.
They get up near the boat, they freak.
Yeah.
Yeah,
all right, Josh.
Tight. I need another gal.
One, two, three.
All right.
Woo!
Beautiful fish. Probably a 60, 65 pound fish. It's a beautiful color. First trip out of Venice, short ride to the rigs, and one big yellowfin in the box. So far, so good.
We're on. We got another one on.
Yeah, we got.
We're back in the game.
Is he pulling?
Oh, yeah.
Never, ever get slack. Just crank.
Oh, there he is. Yeah, he splashed. Swordfish. I saw that nose come up. Keep cranking that thing.
Swordfish. I've never even seen one before. I don't even know what to do.
Got one about 200.
Love action in round two. Crank! Oh yeah, now he feels it, huh?
Looks like we're hooked up on a sword. It's a long haul getting him up, but the reward is great.
At some point, Josh, he may make a big run up. You're the mangled at the crank. The other way, you're gonna feel the burn. All that sleeping you've been doing is gonna finally pay off.
Oh, it is.
Rough. The Marlins were hurt.
How you doing, brother?
Do it.
All right, here we go.
I wish I would've went to the gym.
You're good. You're crank. It's called the Gladiator of the Sea for a reason.
Good job.
Want to swap, brother?
Yeah.
If you got to swap, now's the time.
All right, Josh. Okay. I'm sweating so hard.
I bet you are.
Whew. I got a lot of line in, but that took a lot out of me.
This is the battle of the sword, bro. You think he's right there, and then he might go down 400 or 500 feet
in the next run. He's gonna hang on.
He's getting up there. I got to the color. We're working a good strategy here.
Okay.
All right, we got
a strategy. Arm
is
smooth and steady. He's going back towards the front. Get around, let him go. My man! Pow, 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 we're getting close.
He's coming back.
Go ahead, Josh.
No, there's no switching now. There's no switching now.
Oh, you kidding me?
No, I'm not kidding. Now is when you lose him.
Crank, crank, crank.
I want this fish. Oh, he just came off. Pulled the hook.
Damn it, boy. Oh, yeah, he's off.
Pulled up. Not sure there was any slack. Sometimes you pull the hook.
Oh, we were right there.
We were right there.
Come on. Ah.
It's a lot of cranking to stay focused and keep the rod bent, keep it tight. You gotta, all the fighting they do elongates that hole where the hook is, and if you let it go slack, all they do is one head shake and they're off, they're gone.
Did I do something wrong? I swear I kept that thing tight.
It happens, you lose more than you catch.
There's nothing you can do.
It's crushing to lose any fish, but a 200-pound sword, that is just brutal. The silver lining is our first Venice trip delivered two of the most profitable species in a matter of hours. That battle was epic. Man versus beast. Ready for a cocktail.
Hi, bud.
I think we should stick around. I mean, we're just starting to get good at it.
This place is a potential gold mine. But Jeff and Casey add new clients every day. I gotta make a move before it's too late. It's Matt O'Brien.
Yes, sir.
How we doing, my man?
I'm good.
What's going on, my friend?
Good, man. What's going on?
Oh, you know, just been fishing down your neck of the woods here for a bit, kind of learning the lay of the land, kind of looking to maybe possibly start selling some fish around this region.
Selling some fish?
Yes, sir. Matt O'Brien is a friend of Heavy's and one of the top wholesalers in the Southeast. He deals directly with restaurants and high-end private chefs, sourcing whatever product they need. But we've done quite well in the past couple years over in Hawaii. We're looking to expand. Follow my dad's dream. He kind of had an idea to do something like this, but he never could put the pieces together to make it happen.
So tell me what kind of fish you're used to fishing over there in Hawaii. What are y'all fishing for?
Our big thing is tuna, ahi tuna, yellowfin.
Okay.
You know, that's your bread and butter. We got a good market for that. You guys have a lot of them down here.
We have a lot of them down here.
Yes, sir.
Absolutely. Got a lot of pelagic.
Yeah, as you read about this place, and I've been out and fished it, I've never seen fishing quite like it.
You know,
all around the world for these things.
You know, I'd like to, you know, work with you a little bit. I'm just, when I get an order, my name's on the line. I have to fulfill that order. And then, you know, I know the guys that I have, they get it. And if I take from them and offer you some of that, you can't let me down.
Yeah.
Look, if I give you a piece of this order, you got to deliver it. Because I'm going to tell these guys, and these guys service the best restaurants in New Orleans. Mm-hmm. You know, New Orleans is famous for that seafood, you know that.
Yes, sir. When I give somebody my word, you know, we get it done.
That's what I like to
win it. I'm hungry, ready for a start. Just want to get my foot in the door.
Absolutely. You know, after we talked on the phone the other day, I made a few calls, some people I know in the business. You know, you got a good reputation. They say you worked hard, and I feel for, you know, your goals with your father and all of that. But let me tell you something, man. In this business down here, with these restaurants we supply in New Orleans and all, you can't promise something and not deliver. Yeah. Because that's the end of it. When it comes down to it, business is business. It's a hard business, hard people.
Well, if we've been doing it for a couple years in Hawaii,
yeah, no
we're
doubt.
Still in business
no doubt.
There. That's a pretty cutthroat market, I think. Give us a shot. We'll let you know.